Welcome to Conversations Live. For more than a decade, we've brought you the best in books, entertainment, celebrity interviews, and current events. When the movers and shakers of the world have something to say to you, they say it to us first. Now celebrating 17 years of broadcasting success, here's your host, Cyrus Webb.
And welcome back, everyone, to Conversations Live. I'm your host, Cyrus Webb. Glad you all could join us once again, both for our radio audience here in the South and our online audience tuning in. Thanks to our friends at iHeartRadio, as well as Amazon Music Podcast. We're glad you all could be with us as well. We're excited to welcome actress Kate Watson to our program today to talk to us not only about her love of acting, but also what it's been like for her to do what she loves and to share that experience with all of you. She's beginning the month of February with a brand new movie on Lifetime called Killer Advice. We'll talk to her not only about the movie, but also what she's looking forward to you guys taking away from it, and maybe even what you can look forward to more from her this year. Kate, thank you so much for the time. Really appreciate it.
Oh, I appreciate it also. Thanks, Cyrus.
Well, look, you know, it's great to have some bright spots, right, in 2021, something for us to be able to look
exactly.
forward to, you know, especially when it comes to a new film. A lot of us, of course, enjoy being able to get together and watch movies, and we get to do it in the comfort of our own home. So what has it been like for you, Kate, to be able to do something that you love and then to see people respond mm-hmm. to it the way they are?
You know, as a true lover of film and consumer of film and television, you know, to be a part of this world and this craft, it's so thrilling. I think that, you know, I got into this industry because growing up as a little girl, I connected so much with the films and the television that I was seeing, things that would move me and make me see life through a different pair of eyes or an experience from a character. To be that person who's been able to share that is a really rewarding thing. Whenever I get to hear from anyone who's seen a movie of mine and relates to it, it's just a really good feeling. So I love that part of it.
Yeah. You know, I think, you know, for myself, as I've kind of followed your journey and even in prepping for this segment, I think the other cool thing is you've been able to bring different types of characters to life. Is that also part of the fun for you at this point, Kate, being able to not only to challenge yourself, but also to get your audience to see you in different roles?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, I think that what draws me to any role is really being able to experience a totally different person that's very separate to me as Kate Watson.
Yeah.
And I feel like, you know, like free spirit, I'm kind of easygoing. I'm originally from the Hawaiian Islands. So we kind of have that easygoing nature there in the islands. And I tend to be drawn to very, you know, dramatic roles, roles that are challenging, that kind of shake me up. I'm a pretty strong woman, and roles that are very vulnerable. So being able to experience these characters and these different parts of myself kind of break me open in a different way. And that's a really rewarding experience, to kind of go through that process of experiencing life through a kind of different set of eyes. Yeah.
I had the opportunity, it was last year, Kate, to talk to Michael Dvorsen, who you worked with on another great project on Lifetime, Her Deadly Groom. And one of the things, of course, he talked about with that cast is, you know, that for one thing, the camaraderie, but also what it was like to be around people just as passionate as you are. So talk to us about that for you. I mean, you've been able to work with some amazing people along the way, and they've said the same thing about you. I mean, what has that been like for you, encouraging you in what can be a challenging business?
Yeah, I mean, I think that this is such a collaborative art form that it really, if people don't understand filmmaking in general, it is, you know, it's not just the actors putting this film together. There are so many different moving parts from, you know, the crew, of course, our filmmakers, our producers, our director. And it's such a collaboration and such a labor of love that every single moment you share on a set with these people, you become kind of this unified force, this family. And so you really, you know, that energy that you feel when you're on set can either be one of collaboration or one that's maybe not as supportive. And you can see that in the film. And I think, you know, the final product definitely will suffer if you don't kind of have that, that unity. And everybody, especially on any sort of independent project, I mean, you go into it knowing that it's certainly an undertaking. You're usually working very quickly, and to keep up that pace, kind of like a marathon, you've got to really buckle down and kind of come together and work really, really hard together. So I've been really fortunate to work with some incredible people and some friends that I still have from sets. And that just definitely makes the difference in the entire experience also.
Yeah. I'm from Mississippi, Kate, so I have to mention someone from our home state that you've been able to work with, and that is Eric Roberts. You work with him, of course, on Killer Advice. You work with him on the other film that I mentioned, Her Deadly Groove.
I think I've done three, yeah.
Wow, that's amazing. So, I mean, when you think about that, the individuals you've been able to work with, do you still at this point have those wow moments in your career, even looking at all the great things you've been able to do?
Of course. I mean, and truth be told, I meet wonderful people that are actors and non-actors all the time on sets. I'm inspired by people who are so in love with what they do. You know, they raise your bar. They raise your standards up. And when you're working with someone who takes their craft seriously, but at the same time is willing to kind of meet you there in the moment, an actor like Eric Roberts that is open to collaboration, but at the same time, like, really just is willing to kind of meet you in the moment and take it to the next level. I appreciate that as an actor. And there's nothing that will come but a great performance from that when you're just open and present and willing to kind of, you know, be truthful and be open to your partner who's in the scene with you.
Yeah, what a great thing, and what a great reminder, I think, for all of us, regardless of our profession. I want to say for those who are just tuning in, either on the radio side or online, we're excited to welcome actress Kate Watson to our program today. We're talking to Kate not only about her journey in doing what she loves in front of the camera, but also the great projects she's been able to be part of, as well as the cast she's been able to work with. So that brings us back to Killer Advice. I mean, what was it about this particular film, Kate, that spoke to you?
Well, it started with the filmmakers. It's actually the same team that brought you Her Deadly Groom. So you've seen that film.
Yeah.
And so I have a profound respect for those filmmakers. Our director, Jared Cohn, this is my third film with him. And I think that the most that an actor can ask of their director is to have a trusting relationship, and we certainly have that. So when he actually sent me this script, it was certainly something that I have never kind of delved into the world of a psychological thriller before. It's a character, Beth Curtis, is someone who, she really, from the outside, looks like a woman who has the ideal life, right? She's got the professional job that she's successful in. She's got the beautiful family, a beautiful home. But an experience that she goes through causes her immense trauma. And it dives into the delicate subject matter of what trauma and mental health kind of do to somebody who's experienced a traumatic attack. And I think that the appeal of the role was being able to kind of, you know, to speak on a subject matter like mental health that I think is so important that we don't speak enough about. But also as an actor to dive into what does that mean that I have to go through emotionally, and how do I portray this character honestly. And I really wanted to portray Beth in a way that was very grounded. It was very realistic. I didn't want any sheen. I wanted it to be as real as possible. And so it was certainly an undertaking, but probably one of the most rewarding experiences I've ever had on a set.
Wow, what a cool thing. Definitely invite our audience to be on the lookout for it. Again, on February the 5th on Lifetime. We're going to also let you guys know how to stay connected with Kate. Kate, one of the ways that you're kind of keeping us connected on all the things that you're doing is social media. I think social media took on a whole new life and importance for us in 2020 because it became a big way of how we were able to stay connected. What has it been like for you? I noticed when I was prepping for this, of course, one of your last posts was about Killer Advice, and you've been able to share bits of your own life with us. What has that been like for you to have that connection with your audience there?
Oh, you know, I think it's so much fun to have any sort of feedback in this digital age where people can actually reach out to you after they've seen one of your films. Feedback from people who have seen my work and love it, or people who recommend films to me or books to me. I love that as well. But I think that certainly in this challenging last year that we've all had where we've been isolated, that human connection is vital. It's vital, not only to, keeping us kind of, you know, going in life, but also mentally, our mental health. And so any sort of connection that we can have is great, right? So that's certainly been a part of it. And I do love to kind of talk about what projects I'm up to and things that I'm experiencing. So yeah, certainly connect with me there on Instagram at Actress Kate Watson and Facebook at Actress Kate Watson.
All right. So she's made it very easy for you guys, and we will make sure that we tag those links for you guys for those joining us via the podcast. Kate, great conversation with you. Congratulations on Killer Advice and all the great things coming your way. And looking forward to having you back on the program again.
Oh, thank you so much. I appreciate it. Take care of yourself.
Hey, you as well, Kate. Thank you. And we thank your audience for tuning in to another great segment of Conversations Live. Until next time, I'm your host, Cyrus Webb, saying, as always, enjoy your day, enjoy your life, enjoy your world. Thank you all for choosing Conversations Live. Now let's go make today amazing. Take care.